Heating and cooling your home is super important. If you're thinking about buying a standard split system to heat and cool your home, one of the first things you may be introduced to is a calculator to size up the unit for the space you're wanting to heat and cool. And you can forget about heating and cooling your whole home with just one or two split system installations. Well, this is a three-bedroom home, which is being heated and cooled with just a 2.6 kilowatt split system, and it's doing it quite comfortably. These calculators do not take into consideration a high-performing building envelope. Meanwhile, no matter how terrible your home is, a correctly sized ducted heating system is considered an acceptable way to heat your whole home, because when you turn it on, you instantly feel the heat that it's producing. One thing is for sure, the leakier your home, even if the system is correctly sized for your house, you will have higher energy bills if you're trying to keep comfortable. If your home has both ducted heating and evaporative cooling, what money you might save in cooling, you will most definitely spend on heating, because hot air rises and pushes straight through all your evaporative cooling ductwork. Gas ducted heating systems can have massive openings in the return air cavity, located in an internal wall, which also creates an induced pressure on your home when it's in operation, forcing warm conditioned air throughout all the holes in your home. Let's talk building envelope performance. All these ducted systems complicate the building envelope, so let's simplify. By removing the ducted heating system and removing the evaporative cooler, introducing exhaust systems with draft stoppers, and just generally sealing up the home, while at the same time retrofitting insulation on all air barrier surfaces. And remember, insulation consistency is key. You won't need to install a split system in every room. If energy has got nowhere to go, it will just hang around. House temperatures and relative humidity levels stay more stable, and you need way less energy to keep comfortable. Humidity control is super important, and it's as important as temperature for comfort. It can actually be more important because it can impact comfort, health, and controlling mold. The further your home stays away from dew point, the less likely mold will grow on surfaces in your home. The Daikin US7 is one of those splits that can control humidity. Most split systems dry the inside air when they are in a cooling mode, but when heating, relative humidity goes down slowly because warmer air expands and you can store more moisture in it. The ultimate humidity for human health and comfort is around 40 to 60%. So why is a split system more efficient for heating than a gas ducted heater? Energy losses from the ducted distribution system is a massive part of it. A ducted heating system can actually aggravate air leakage. If air from outside is being sucked into the return, bypassing filtration, your ducted heating system will push conditioned air to the outside during its operation. With a single split system, if your building envelope is inadequate, you can heat or cool a smaller closed off area of your home. Ducted heating, it's either everything or nothing. Reverse cycle split systems are great because they don't complicate the building envelope like ducted systems can. However, there are negating factors. Installing multiple split systems in a home and completely neglecting building performance is a commonly overlooked issue. Buying a cheaper, less efficient split system because you have heaps of solar capacity. Get just one or two high quality, efficient split systems that also control humidity and provide fresh air for your home. With the money you save on labor, spend some money on air tightness and insulation consistency and shading combined with double glazing or triple glazing. Installers leave big gaping holes in the plaster behind the split system. It's not the best place to have a hole. In fact, it's the absolute worst place to be getting fresh air from. Why would anyone want fresh air from a potential moldy wall cavity? It's dusty and dirty behind there and allows bugs and spiders to come into your home. It also reduces the efficiency of your split system. You also need to clean your split system more often. Even without a big hole behind your split system, you really should be cleaning your filters every 2 weeks. Otherwise, performance of the system can be impacted. Make sure your split system has been sealed to the plaster board where all your refrigerant pipes pass through your wall. This is critical and it's a massive problem in Australia. Box air conditioners are no good. They are super leaky, hugely conductive and super inefficient. These types of systems should be removed, your building envelope reinstated. There are some advertised solar DC split system products out there that directly connect to a solar array advertising free cooling. If you have a good building envelope, why would you waste solar panels on air conditioning and air conditioning only, when you could choose not to use air conditioning and pump your electricity into something else, perhaps an electric car or a home battery system? The energy efficiency benefit from directly injecting DC into a split system does not warrant forcing that power only to go into a split. For more information on reducing your heating and cooling footprint, subscribe to our channel and visit our website at efficiencymatrix.com, where there are many articles that discuss building performance.